In this video, we're going to talk about what is a blood transfusion. A blood transfusion is a safe and common procedure in which blood is given to you through an intravenous line in one of your blood vessels. The procedure takes about 1 to 4 hours depending on how much blood you need. Blood transfusions are done to replace the blood lost during surgery or due to a serious injury. It may also be done if your body can't make enough blood because of a chronic illness. Blood transfusions are very common. Each year, almost 5 million Americans need a blood transfusion. Most blood transfusions go well. Mild complications can occur, and very rarely, serious problems can develop. Here's some information about blood. The heart pumps blood through a network of arteries and veins throughout the body. Blood has many vital jobs. It carries oxygen and nutrients to your body's organs and tissues. Having a healthy supply of blood is important to your overall health. Blood is made up of various parts, including red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, and plasma. Blood is transfused either as whole blood or the parts of the blood. There are different blood types. Every person has one of the following blood types, either A, B, AB, or O. And each person is either Rh positive or Rh negative. So your blood type needs to be compatible with the blood you're getting. If it doesn't, antibodies, which are proteins in your blood, will attack this new blood and make you sick. Blood banks collect, test, and store blood. They carefully screen all donated blood for possible infectious agents such as viruses that can make you sick. Not all transfusions use blood donated from a stranger. If you're going to have surgery, you may need a blood transfusion because of blood loss during the operation. If it's surgery that you're able to schedule months in advance, your doctor may ask whether you would like to use your own blood rather than donated blood. Are there alternatives to a blood transfusion? Well, researchers are trying to find ways to make blood. There's currently no man-made alternative to human blood. However, researchers have developed medications that may help do the job of some of the blood parts. For example, some people who have kidney problems can now take a medicine called erythropoietin that helps their bodies make more red cells. This means fewer transfusions. Surgeons try to reduce the amount of blood lost during surgery so that fewer patients need blood transfusions. Sometimes they can collect and reuse the blood from the surgery itself. Types of blood transfusions really depend on what you have a deficiency on. They can do red blood cell transfusion, platelet transfusion, clotting factor transfusions, and plasma transfusions. What to expect before a blood transfusion? Well, before a blood transfusion, a technician tests your blood to find out what type you are, A, B, AB, or O, Rh positive, Rh negative, and so on. He or she then pricks your finger with a needle to get a few drops of blood or draws the blood from one of your veins. The blood type used in your transfusion must work with the blood type that you're getting. If it doesn't, you can get very sick. Some people have allergic reactions. Even when the blood given does not work, To prevent this, your doctor may prescribe a medicine to stop allergic reactions. If you have allergies or have had an allergic reaction during the past in another transfusion, your doctor will make every effort to make sure you're safe. Most people don't need to change their diets or activities before or after a blood transfusion. Your doctor will let you know whether you need to make any lifestyle changes prior to this procedure. After the blood transfusion ends, your vital signs are checked, such as temperature, blood pressure, and heart rate. The intravenous line is taken out, and you may have some bruising or soreness for a few days at the site where the IV was inserted. You may need blood tests that show how your body is reacting to the transfusion. Your doctor will let you know about signs and symptoms to watch for and report to him. Let's talk about the risks of a blood transfusion. Most blood transfusions go very smoothly. However, mild problems very rarely, serious problems can occur. Let's talk about allergic reactions. Some people have allergic reactions to the blood given during this transfusion. This can happen even when the blood given is the right blood type. Allergic reactions can be mild or even severe. And symptoms include anxiety, chest or back pain, trouble breathing, fever, chills, flushing, or clammy diaphoresis in your skin, a quick pulse or low blood pressure, nausea, which is the feeling of sickness like you're gonna vomit. A nurse or doctor will stop the transfusion at the first signs of an allergic reaction. The healthcare team determines how mild or severe the reaction is and what treatments are needed, and whether the transfusion can be safely restarted once the symptoms go away. Now let's talk about viruses and infectious diseases related to blood transfusions. Some infectious agents such as HIV can survive in blood and infect the person receiving the blood transfusion. To keep blood safe, blood banks carefully screen donated blood. The risk of catching a virus from a blood transfusion is very low. HIV. Your risk of getting HIV from a blood transfusion is lower than your risk of getting killed by lightning. Only about 1 in 2 million donations might carry HIV and transmit HIV if given to the patients. Hepatitis B and C. The risk of having donation that carries hepatitis B is by 1 in 200,000 and hepatitis C 1 in 2 million. If you receive blood that contains hepatitis virus, you might likely develop the virus. A different disease or a variant of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease or mad cow disease is very rare but fatal brain disorder that can happen from blood transfusions. Again, this is very, very rare. You may also get a sudden fever during or within a day of your blood transfusion. This is usually your body's normal response to white blood cells in the donated blood. Over-the-counter fever medicines usually will treat the fever. Some blood banks remove white blood cells from the whole blood or different parts of blood. This makes it less likely that you will have a reaction of this kind after the transfusion. Iron overload is another complication of blood transfusion. By getting too many blood transfusions can cause too much iron to build up in your blood or an iron overload. People who have a blood disorder like thalassemia, which requires multiple transfusions, are at risk of iron overload. Iron overload can damage your liver, your heart, even other parts of the body. If you have iron overload, you need iron chelation therapy, a medication that binds the iron and removes it from your body. Lung injury. Although it's very unlikely, blood transfusions can damage your lungs, making it hard to breathe. This usually occurs within the first 6 hours after the transfusion, and most patients recover just fine. Autoimmune or acute immune hemolytic reaction is very serious, but also very rare. It occurs if the blood type you get during a transfusion doesn't match or work with your blood type. Your body attacks the new red blood cells, which then produce substances that harm your kidneys. The symptoms include chills, fever, nausea, pain in the chest or back, and dark urine. The doctor will stop the transfusion at the first sign of this reaction. A delayed hemolytic reaction, this is a much slower version of what we just discussed. Your body destroys the red blood cells so slowly that the problem usually goes unnoticed until your red blood cell levels are very, very low. Both acute and delayed hemolytic reactions are common in patients who have had a previous blood transfusion. Lastly, graft versus host disease is a condition in which white blood cells in the new blood attacks your tissues. GVHD is usually fatal. People who have weakened immune system are most likely to develop this complication. Symptoms start within a month of the blood transfusion and include fever, rash, and diarrhea. As you get done watching this video, you may want to take mental notes of the questions that you need answers for before you consent for your blood transfusion. God bless.